distinguished company director with Ferrari Mondial, penthouse in Docklands and villa in Tuscany, seeks fun-loving beauty to share his debentures at Wimbledon. No, I could never fancy a bloke with false teeth. Hello, Trace.
You still in there, are ya? Any longer and you'll get poached. Two to be taken four times a day before meals. What if you ain't got no appetite?
You sure those happy tablets are strong enough?
I don't know. I feel lazy. But maybe I'd feel worse without them. No, couldn't feel worse than this.
Snap out of it, Trace. You can't stay on Tranks for the next 10 years.
It ain't 10 years. For good behaviour, you'll be out on July the 15th, 1997.
What time?
7 a.m. It ain't funny, Sharon. I've lost the man I love. It's all right for you. You're happy they put your Chris away.
I'm not happy. I'm ecstatic.
You be so heartless.
I ain't heartless, Trace. Just honest. They're lovely, these croissants, aren't they?
And I've told you before about eating them in the jacuzzi. Daryl says it bums up the filter. Oh!
Calm down. It's only a few crumbs. Perrier, Camembert. Fromage frais. Whatever happened to egg and bacon? Fried bread, porridge. Sorry, forget I said porridge. Why, are you cold?
Not the fridge, your face.
It's just making conversation.
Well, don't.
Suit yourself. You eating that measly?
What's it look like?
Looks like pig's will, if it's going begging.
Oh, pig's will's right, the noise you make.
I'm just straining out the hard bits from my teeth.
The hard bits are good for you.
That's what Chris used to say when we was courting. Here. Guess what I got in my pocket? He used to say that and all, actually.
What a sock in it, Sharon.
No, 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 it's not a sock. It's a letter addressed to you in a childish, unformed hand. Question is, why is my Chris writing to you?
Look at here, slag bag. It's from Garth. Oh, I bet he's found out about his dad.
You mean he's not Daryl's?
You can always go back to Edmonton, you know. You're supposed to be here to cheer me up.
Sorry, Trace. So what's my nephew got to say for himself?
Dear Mummy and Daddy.
Dear Mummy and Daddy. Must be an echo in here.
I can't, you read it.
Dear Mummy and Daddy, sorry I haven't written before, but I'm having such a super time here, I forgot to. Fisk's is a great school. I've really settled in well. All the stories about bullying and caning and rotten food and cold dorms and sinister homosexual initiation rites aren't true at all. A lovely turn of phrase, isn't it? Mind you, his spelling. Look, initiation rites, R-I-T-E-S.
Oh, wrong with it.
I'm really looking forward to you both coming up to Fisk's on our open day next week. And maybe you can take me into Kettering for a slap-up curry. Not that food here isn't spiffing. I love you both, Garth.
Oh, bless him. Sounds like he's settling in okay.
So when are you going to tell him that his dad's staying at the Queen's Hotel?
Can't. Just can't.
So what are you going to tell him? That his dad's been selected for the first manned space flight to Saturn?
I thought maybe I could say that Daryl's gone to build a conservatory in the Middle East.
For 8 years. Tracy, the Crystal Palace didn't take 8 years.
Don't be so stupid. I thought it all through. See, I picked on the Middle East so that after a few months I could say that Daryl's been taken hostage by Shiite militants.
Shiite's the word.
All right then, Kate AD. What would you tell Garth?
The truth. It'll have to come out in the end.
I can't.
Honesty is the best policy, Trace.
Did you make that up yourself?
No, it was a motto in a box of Christmas crackers I nicked out at low price. Well, we ain't got no bread.
Yeah, well, you know where the shops are.